record this, and it will be posted on the YouTube channel as well tomorrow. So hope you guys just chill along whilst we get it cracking. So you're gonna open up Unreal Engine first. Completely blank project. And then I just need to set up my timer. So here we have a completely empty project. So let's go from here and see how far we can get. Cheers, Guru. Nice to see you, mate. There we go. Here, we're going to need to set up the game mode. And get straight in here, we can create our two things, the controller and the pawn. Drag them into there, and we can also set up the inputs. So I can have move forward and duplicate that one, move right. I'm going to have jump action. Going to be a digital, make sure it's a ball so it's on or off. We're going to duplicate that one a couple of times. We're going to have interact, and we're going to have shoot. interact will be the E button. And shoot. Left mouse. There we have the looking. Which should be the invert of the mouse Y. And we need mouse X for looking left and right. Back into the controller. Add our mapping context, we'll also get the character. Save that as a variable. Okay, so that is 6 minutes in, and we've got the movement done. Let's create our character quickly. Game mode, push play, we should be able to walk around, jump. Hey Archie, nice to see you. I am making a first person wave shooter from scratch, completely a blank project, and seeing how far we can get in 2 hours. So 6 minutes in, we've got the movement down. Next thing is quite a big thing. We are going to be doing randomized loot. So let's start making our gun generator. Very similar to Borderlands. So first thing is you're going to need a structure for all our gun base info that we're going to draw from. Then we're going to need our rate of fire. Our base damage, and our gun type rarity, so how likely it is for this gun to be picked as opposed to something else. Thanks for the follow, Archie. Appreciate it, mate. So now we're going to grab our struct we just made, setting it into a data table, and we're just going to make two very basic guns in the table. A pistol with a rate of fire of 1 per second, damage of 1, gun type rarity of 0.1, 6.6. And we'll have an assault rifle. Rate of fire 2, and damage 0.6, so it's slightly higher, but not crazy high compared to what normally would be. Output 0.4. We're going to need to create a rarity system. Okay, so the first thing you want to do when we generate guns, you want to generate the rarity itself. So we're going to need to create a function to roll a rarity for us. So we go to the blueprint, get our function library, we'll just call this other functions. If I'm going a bit fast for any of this, by all means tell me to slow down and I'll answer any questions you have. That's what I'm here for. I've made a couple of things. I've made a puzzle game as part of a mini game jam with another YouTuber where you had to grind sheep into different colours to open doors. I've made, in the process of making a Pokemon-esque turn-based RPG where you play a gym leader. Using my own creatures and everything like that as well, but I can generally make reasonable amounts of stuff. It's not much 2D though, that's the only thing. I haven't actually tried Scratch, to be fair. It's more like this, where it's a visual base, I think. Scratch. Could be wrong. I started off using things like Game Maker, which was all code to begin with, and now it's not. I think it's more like jigsaw pieces, if I remember rightly. Thought so. So yeah, so if there's anything that you, I mean, if you're interested in Unreal Engine, I do have a YouTube channel as well, which is all about basics, and learning from very, very beginner side of thing. My first series is all about making Pong, just to show you how basic it is. There's also a Discord as well. Feel free to join. I'm on there. I might not be able to answer questions all the time, but of course, if I am able to, I do. I've also got a community of creators. One of them's just released a game, and the other one released a game a couple of months ago. So I'm actually a bit behind on that aspect. Thank you very much. Okay, so the first thing we can do is now roll for rarity. The Discord server. There is reasonably new. I've got around 100 people or so on there. I'll have to recheck to see if the link is the same. It's been a while since I've streamed, and this is the first time I'm streaming a bit of game dev as well. So next up, we need to roll for gun type. So we need to do something very similar. Then you need to click in the rules, and it's very simple. It should be as easy as just agreeing to the rules, and then you should be able to see the rest of them. No, not yet. We're still halfway through. I'm on 45 at the moment. I am, obviously you've just seen the message now, but the reason why I'm asking for the followers is I'm doing a charity stream in October, November time. And it's the second time I've done it. This time I'm hoping to get a little bit more than I did last time. I actually managed to raise a good £500-600. This time round, I'm hoping to do more, and to do that, I've got an AI bot which responds to messages that you can put into chat. Or the idea is to use channel points to use the AI bot, and in order to get channel points, you need to be an affiliate. So there is reason, there is method to the madness. And I just need, yeah, we need to make that the next amount, and then we can get working on that, because it's all for charity in the end. Gun type. Next up, we need to roll for stats. I'm going to create a projectile. I'm going to do very similar to what we did with the guns. We're going to do that with the projectiles as well. So, well, 6 months to get 5 more. I'm hoping I should be able to do it. Feel free to spread the word to anyone else that you know that wants to learn game dev. I will be doing some more game streams as well. I will be streaming game dev once a week, and then the following week we'll be playing the game, because that's what the stream is going to be about, the charity stream. It's going to be playing games. It's going to be me making a fool of myself, which is normally the best way. Thanks for joining. Appreciate it, man. I will be here next Thursday, playing probably maybe a bit of Bellatro or something like that. Yeah, it's cool, Guru. It's cool, man. Okay, now I've made the gun base info, now I need to make a new struct for the actual gun info itself. Damage projectile. Give a little bit of variance as well as the rarity multiplier. Now we can fit in some rate of fire. Add that to the gun info. Make it sealant. Rather than anything else, and the projector will have to change shortly. So let's go add a level to our user. But you want, so it's 50% chance to go down here. Then you want 30% chance, a 10% chance to go down a level. A 40% chance to go up a level. Until it fails, in which case. Okay, and we want the projectile to be 'Cause the actual information of the projectile for it to work. Roll stats. Level, and these are all stats now. Hey, finally got it working. It's annoyingly took 5 minutes to get that sorted. Minutes in, I've got a gun generator working. Right, player. Let's add two guns. Level saved. Shoot. So now I need to get to projectile. I need to actually make the projectile do something now. And simulate, and off it goes. Okay, so we need to get player camera manager. From 100 to 5,000. And then you go back to the player and add a shoot. I'll do this over triggered as well. And by default, you want to set the rate of fire, let's just set to 3. Okay, so that's done, and let's take a look back at the controller again. That's why. Moving is done, shooting is done. Okay, next up, let's go and make a gun pickup. So, 1 hour and 12 minutes to go. Well ahead of schedule. Let's add a swap box. Make sure that the collision on the sphere collision, the interaction, is changed to a custom. It's got to be block on the visibility, and everything else can stay overlapped. That's fine. So we simulate it. It spins round. There's a light on it. Wonderful. And we want gun info. And then we're going to need to make an interface now, so we go to blueprint interface, interactable. to go into the inventory, so we want to go to, for now, we'll just set it as game, as gun one. And we'll remove the collision from the cube as well. So we have it set up, so it's roll, then choose this and get your generated info and shove that in there. For now, we'll just spawn that in there. Cool, so now I need to set up an interaction. Location forward vector. Only want that to happen once every time you push the button, so you push the E button instead. Lovely. Let's make a small HUD class. nearly halfway through and nearly done most of the test run. See how far we can get. and change it to be invisible. Where is the visibility? Then on the character, you want to always check. Always check to see if it hits the gun pickup. I see you still there, Guru. I see you still there, mate. See, it's interesting because you actually get to see what I can do, because I've seen what you can do, obviously. And you've seen my tutorials, but you've never actually seen me develop. And this is an hour in. And you'll be able to see what I've done shortly. Yeah, not far. It's a shame that RG couldn't stay, but it is. We just need more people to join these streams. Hint, hint, those watching the VOD. Start making some enemies to run at us. Let's be over to a new world. Okay, that's not terrifying at all. We'll put that speed down. Now create an enemy spawner. So this bit here, it's spawning enemies in a ring, so a minimum distance around a location. So this is going to spawn anywhere randomly around the character beyond a radius of 1500. Just place. Okay, 45 minutes left to go. There is amount, health, minus damage amount, is new health. Enemy is at the health component, but I need to make a child and call it enemy health. Because we're going to need to override what they do on death. Health component, give them one health for now. And we go to our projectile. Give that a damage, which is going to have to be exposed and spawn, and we're going to have to give it all its stats as well. By default, it doesn't have any gravity. Let's spawn a couple of the guns across. So it should start killing them now. Let's have some actual damage first. Okay, that's something's not right with that. Okay, that was fixed. Let's make an effect quickly. opponent's got 5 now. Let's move on to something different. Okay, that's that. So I need to do on two buttons now when you click on them. Well, the buttons didn't default as a variable, I don't know, but off we go. Got to pick up. That's why that's just completely wrong. That's got to be the gun info of the widget, not anything else. 26 minutes. Okay. Let's add an experience item. Simulate the physics. Let's try setting that as a variable as well. Okay, that's fine. Give this a random 214. Plug that in. Then destroy the reactor. Okay, add experience. Fires here. Cheers for coming on, man. Appreciate it. Last 7 minutes now. Just a matter of hopefully getting a couple of bits and pieces on. I might add a bar, see if I've got time for that. So let's add that very quickly. Add a blueprint. I'll just add it as a progress bar along the bottom. Just in the bottom of the screen, just for on the main screen, so that's fine. It's not going to be anything fancy, we've got 6 minutes left. Let's get a reference to our player. And now we can go back to the bind for it and we can grow it straight from there. Let's add a small border. We'll get the little one there. Now we just need to add EXP. Okay, let's promote that instead. And we use that to get the active location. Okay, that's fine. 3 minutes left. Let's add an enemy spawner into our enemy spawner. Health multiplier. And we'll add our into the begin play function to set health. We're only there, only 2 minutes to go now. So if we add some health to that. Set out every spawner. Every time it spawns, we want to add 0.02. So every 50 is going to. 0.05. Let's change it. I'm going to start at 0.05. Okay, well at the moment, I've got things up, I can still can't run through them, but I can shoot them. I can't be damaged at the moment. At the moment you can just shoot everything else. But there's no errors or anything, so let's change the gun pickup slightly. Gun generator, because we need to add a level to do something to do with it. That is time. So, in 2 hours, this is what we've managed to do. Let's just play in a few ports. So we can move, we can jump, we can shoot. We have pickups. This has damage of zero. In fact, all of these do damage of zero because I just changed something and broke it. So let's just change that very quickly. Let's just remove that. And yeah, not bad going that. In another, if we were to do another 2 hours on top of this, then we might be able to complete a working loop for a game. Hopefully we'll be able to also make a couple of changes to the guns and how they generate. Maybe have different effects going on, have actual waves instead of anything else for the enemies as well, so that the enemies will only spawn 10 in the first wave, 20 in the second wave, and so on and so on, rather than just constantly doing that. It's more Vampire Survivors-esque sort of spawning at the moment. But yeah, it's not bad. That's pretty much everything that I'm going to do on stream, if I'm honest. If there is anything else, then obviously I've got the Discord, I've got the link to the Discord and the YouTube channel in the profile. So by all means, please go check them out, and I shall see you next Thursday for a gaming session rather than dev. Thank you guys very much. I'll catch you later.